Do you think that our current, let's see, our current credit scoring system will be replaced by a social credit scoring system or a combination of both? Let's see. I do think we'll see a combination of both of them in certain circumstances. I'm not sure how they'd implement that social credit score. It might be based on how many tickets you have, DUI. It might not just be you've got to go to jail for 3 days. It might be some sort of social demerit that, it could be social media. It might be that, Jim, where if you say something wrong on social media, that you get a social demerit, and there's like a council, like a social demerit council, and they vote on, and it's probably, I'm going way off on a tangent here, but they'd probably just have some sort of algorithm for it. So it would be AI. So the AI bots just determine what it should be. But they kind of have that. Like it's if you have a certain ticket, you get points. And if you get a certain amount of points, you lose your driver's license. So same type of thing. If you say something that you shouldn't say on Twitter and it's deemed inappropriate, they give you a certain amount of points. And if you get 10, well, then you might not get a loan, or at least I think you'd probably pay a higher interest rate, something like that. So I don't know how close we are, but I see that being a reality down the road at some point, especially because we are moving so we're just moving in a direction of more and more and more political correctness. And to where you just, and also we're moving in a direction where the whole country is so divisive and one group hates the other group and we're all out to get each other. And it's this religion that I've been talking about a lot in our videos, that in American society, the our emphasis on religion has decreased substantially over the past few decades. And you could say, well, that's good or bad. We're not here to debate that. But the bottom line is if you have less religion, then you got to fill that void with something, because we as human beings, we have to have meaning in our life. It's just there's no other way around it. So, I mean, I would argue that Christianity is a heck of a lot better than Republican or Democrat. But, I guess that's not up for me to decide. That's up to each individual. But I think that if we keep going that direction, which I think we are, especially if Trump starts his own network, I don't think too many people are thinking about it. It's not my idea. It's Dr. Pippa Malgrim's, excuse me. And she's on Macro Voices. I heard her discuss this there for the first time. And it just makes a lot of sense to me when you think about the Trump's personality, and you think about what's happening right now with, or what's happened consistently with CNN and his kind of battle with the media, his ego, what's happened with Twitter, and the fact that that type of individual, and they're usually guys, because I think there's just that very small percentage of guys that are just hardwired to just go, want more and more and more. Sometimes they just want more money. They want more power. It's just more. That how much more? I don't know. Just more. And they just never ever quit. And we see it with like Warren Buffett. And I'm not saying Warren Buffett is just like Donald Trump, but I am saying that it's people like that that just, they just continue to do what they're doing and continue to want more success in or achieve more in life in whatever they're trying to do. And they just do it till you put them 6 feet under. They never ever stop until they just physically or mentally can't. And it's weird. It's a bizarre thing that just, and it's not all guys, and it's occasionally you can get a gal, but not like that. I've rarely seen a gal that at 90 years old, she's out there trying to make another $1 billion just to prove that she can. It's a weird hardwiring there. And I believe that Trump is like that. I'm not here to say I'm a fan or not a fan of Trump. I dislike all politicians equally, but I think he's got that hardwiring. I just don't see him, like Carl Icahn is another example of that. The guys just won't retire. Like they just won't stop. And I just don't see Trump just saying, okay, I'm not president anymore. Well, I'll just go back to doing a TV show. Or I'll just go back to doing my real estate. I don't think so. Guys like Trump that get that taste of whatever it is they want, whether it's money, power, fame, they always want more. They never want to stay at the same level, or heaven forbid, go down a notch or do something that gives them less power than they had before, or less money or less fame. They always have to do something where they're achieving more. And the only thing, in my opinion, that you could do that would increase your power even more than being president of the United States is to control your own media company. And I don't know how on earth I got off on that topic. Oh, man. But yeah, I think the last question was Jim, which had absolutely nothing to do with what I was talking about. But yeah, I think that credit scoring system, we're going to, unfortunately, see something like that in the future. And oh, yeah, that's what I was saying. With the Biden administration being in office and us moving closer or becoming more and more politically correct as a society, I just see them doing something like that. And of course, it's going to be for your safety. It's got to be for your safety. It's going to be for your safety. It's going to be because this group has had all these problems in the past, and we have to protect this group, and we have to be a civilized society. And if you're not part of this, you know, one thing that I heard my buddy Chris Irons with Quote the Raven podcast, he tweeted out the other day, and I think it's something we really need to start thinking about, is at what point will society deem those who believe in Austrian economics or libertarianism to be domestic terrorists? And I know it kind of sounds, yeah, George, you know, you're going too far. But if you think about kind of the core belief system in Austrian economics, very small government, you know, sound money, gold, independent thinking, kind of the rugged individual type thing. I mean, those are beliefs that are becoming less and less popular in the mainstream, to the point where if you're not if you're not all about the greater good, then you're on the other team. And therefore, by default, you're whatever label we put over that entire group, right? It's this crazy, crazy type of mindset where we're seeing people as groups instead of as individuals. We're devolving as a society. We need to see people as individuals, for heaven's sakes.